The Supreme Court had to decide whether or under what circumstances the Fourth Amendment permits police officers to conduct a warrantless search of the digital contents of an individual's cell phone seized from the person at the time of arrest.
So today we're going to talk about Mr. David Riley. David Riley is a gang member. One day when Mr. Riley and a few of his friends were just hanging out in the neighborhood, Mr. Webster, a rival gang member, was driving by. And all of a sudden, Mr. Riley and his friends start shooting at Mr. Webster's car. Bang, 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 bang. Mr. Webster crashed his car, and oh no! Is that good? So, fast forward to August 22nd. Mr. Riley gets pulled over for having expired registration tags. Officer Dunnigan walks up to his car and says, "License and registration, please." And comes to find out that Riley actually is driving with a suspended driver's license. Officer Dunnigan walks up to Riley and says, "Sir, I'm sorry, but we're going to have to tow and impound your car because you're driving with a suspended driver's license." Officer Dunnigan took it upon himself to perform a search in the vehicle and came across two handguns. Officer Dunnigan thinks to himself, this is interesting. I think I'll take this in. From the discovery of the handguns, Mr. Riley is placed under arrest. While under arrest, Officer Dunnigan performs a search through Mr. Riley's cell phone without a warrant. The search of Mr. Riley's cell phone uncovered evidence linking him to the shooting earlier that month. Mr. Riley's attorney moved to strike the cell phone evidence. "Your Honor, I move to strike all cell phone evidence from this trial." The judge is not in favor of Mr. Riley. "Motion denied. This evidence will be used in trial." In the end, Riley was convicted of three charges.
Now get this. The Supreme Court justices had to decide. Does this violate the Fourth Amendment? I'm pretty sure that this is an unreasonable search and seizure.
American Library Association said, if the people could... American Library Association said, if the police can search this guy's phone without a warrant, what stops them from searching anyone's phone? Our cell phones have way too much personal information on them. And then the state of California says, phones are too dangerous because they can be weaponized. This helps our officers prevent it. The Supreme Court decided on June 25th... Oh, there's some guy walking. Awkward. The Supreme Court decided on June 25th, a year later, with a 9-0 vote, police cannot search digital information on a cell phone without a warrant.
The only exception is if the cell phone is within the arrestee's immediate control and if that endangers the police officers. This guy wasn't. He wasn't presenting any real danger to them with the phone.
Ta-da! With the advancement of technology, now we have digital protection. Is that good?